I'm Deborah Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. Overall, it was a pretty quiet week, but we did start to get some earnings. Scott's Miracle-Gro reported that its fiscal third quarter revenue came in at $1.49 billion. That was an increase of 28% over last year, and it beat the Yahoo analyst estimates for just $1.3 billion. The company said that its hydroponic subsidiary called Hawthorne, those sales increased 72% to $302 million. Things are going so well at Scott's that they bonused the employees that weren't even supposed to get a bonus. And they also increased their guidance for the full year sales, the adjusted earnings, and the free cash flow. While Afria reported their earnings, and it was a bit of a mixed bag, on the net revenue side, they reported $152 million. That was an increase of 18% over last year, and it beat the analyst estimates. Unfortunately, though, they reported net losses of $98 million versus last year's net income of $15.7 million. The stock took a beating as a result. The company blamed all of it on COVID. Pot Network Holdings said that their revenue fell 41% down to $15 million in 2019 versus 2018's net revenue of $25 million. The company said that their revenue fell because of an FDA warning letter that they got and then a paring down of the product line. MYM Nutraceuticals says it is buying Biome-Gro for $12 million Canadian dollars. Biome-Gro is a Canadian-based company with national and international business interests. The company has a subsidiary called Highland-Gro that is licensed to cultivate, process, and sell cannabis. And finally, as announced in early June, Clever Leaves is making progress toward listing on the NASDAQ through the Schultz SPAC. That deal is expected to close in the fourth quarter, and the company will be known as Clever Leaves Holdings. And that's it for this week. Everyone, stay safe out there. I'm Deborah Borchardt with the Green Market Report.